Hey folks, and welcome to the Pipnotic Symposium for the 11th of December, 2020. Today we're just going to run through a bunch of different pairs. I'll start here on the Swiss franc, Japanese yen. This pair on the weekly is really pushing high. You can see that we have lower lows, so we have demand supporting price, and price is able to compromise these swing points here. And so this is just showing us that we have a really keen interest on supporting the price of the Swiss franc Japanese yen. We've reacted to this weekly demand, and price left. Price revisited the chart, and then we left. And so we have a keen interest on looking to buy. And on the hourly chart, there is a lovely area, which I've marked off, that we will have a look at, and that is down here. This is the 115.13 area, so just around the big figure. So we want the stop well below the big figure, but we're looking at something about here. And this is interesting because if you look on the 4-hour chart, we formed this base, we defined a buy zone here. Okay, price poked into it, we move that lower. Okay, and then price tested that buy zone, and then we started to form demand below price. We had a nice turnaround here. We had a bit of a liquidity exploration just down here. Price left, we wriggled north, and then we had a big departure from this area just here, which is very clear on the hourly chart. So this would be a very keen place, I think, to begin to entertain the idea of buying Swiss francs and selling Japanese yens. And if we have a look at this area, you can see how we had an attempt. So we formed this area of supply here, price tested it, we moved through it. This one cut through it, qualifying this area as supply, which was tested once, twice. Price left, qualifying something up here as supply. This area accumulated just below the area, and then we popped north. And this area is still untested. Notice from the release point, which is these white candles, price has not been. So this is just a very interesting place that we could consider to onboard some long positions. So I'm just going to move this up like this. Then we'll leave it like that and see what happens. Okay, let's just continue moving forward. Let's have a look at the British pound, Japanese yen. The British pound has been selling off. Now there's a lot of uncertainty regarding Brexit. Are they going to make this deal here within the next few days or not? Who knows what's going to happen, but there's a lot of uncertainty, and uncertainty is not a good thing. So careful with the British pound for the time being. But technically speaking, we do have, let's go to the weekly chart, we do have price wriggling higher, but notice that price did not manage to move above here. So we actually had probably a monthly area of supply. Yes, we did, just here. It was tested, and price left here. We moved below this low here. We tested this. Price went down to the opposing area. This is not demand on this time frame because we did not manage to consume this. Price left, and now looks like we're testing the child and retreating. So that's telling us that we have maybe a keen interest on seeing this pair move low. And we actually had a really nice, a lovely area here, which has now been tested. And this is an area of supply because, number one, it consumed this, but also we removed this. And this is an area of demand because price, when it left here, price managed to move above this high here. Okay, and so price is just looking to move lower. So looking at the smaller time frames, we do have this, which looks interesting, but I'd be careful about entertaining that because it's just a little bit high risk because of the fact that a price is testing this and moving lower. But it could be a place that we could see some shorter term positions, or maybe some profit taking from the top here, that we'll see price form some kind of reaction here. But we did have a really nice kind of a parent and child. This is not a real parent, this is actually another child testing this area here. And so price left here, we almost came back to here, we tested it, formed this base, we did not manage to hold away, we came back. And so that's telling us that price is probably going to wriggle pretty deep into this area and potentially move into here. So I wouldn't even consider this because price didn't manage to do anything. But on the small time frames, there's going to be something in here. Alternatively, due to the fact that we don't really have any supply until down here, you could consider selling, which is in line with the greater period. So if you go to the smaller time frames, you'll probably be able to pinpoint these nice little areas. So if we go to all the way to the 15-minute chart, yeah, nothing terribly attractive on this time frame. You can just see a lot of mess for the time being. So there's nothing there that I would look forward to. This is a lovely area here. Poke into the area. We had a real sharp run higher. So liquidity exploration, price left. We moved sideways. We distributed, sold, distributed, and then sold. So we had a really nice push away from that area there. But I mean, this has already happened, so there's nothing to do for the time being there until either much lower down here, which on the smaller time frame we could adjust to be right here. And this is actually, as we spoke about in one of our other videos, we have a very clear liquidity exploration going on here, where we have a push lower, price moving high. You see how price was going all the way up here. A lot of people were thinking that this was it, price is going to go down, and so maybe they started to buy, put their stops below here, price was run down, releasing liquidity into the market that could be used to fill the big institutional orders. Price went down, we found them, you can see by the size of the wick, and then price started to go higher. This is again onboarding some longs with stops lower down here. Price came down, we had another push lower, and then price finally managed to move away. And you can see that on this big area here, price managed to release from this area just here. But due to the fact that there's a lot of trading in this area, I would not consider doing anything until price got here, because this is where price left from. This the area of accumulation. These four candles here are related. This is where the slingshot was pulled back to, and so this would be the place that I would look to buy. And that is down here, the 133.65 area. So that's a pretty interesting area. We did have this nice area here that was formed. The software found it. This is demand because it removed this supply. This is supply because we moved below this, and we removed this 4 hours demand over here. So the beginning of the buy zone was here. Price went to it, exploring, trying to find liquidity. We had to go all the way back down to the demand, and this is where we found it. Price left. And so price is probably going to move through this pretty easily. And so that just tells us that we are keen to begin to sell, maybe selling it at some patterns up here. Let's have a look what we have. If we do look at this. Yeah, so you want to look for a place where price tested. We had this one removed. This tested it. Price kind of respected that area, then moved through it. We accumulated, we popped through it, we tested it. So we didn't have any close below that, and the closes below that originated from here. So let's just box this off just here. And this is the area that's responsible for moving price below that. And if you want to look for where the closes are, you can also simply click on the line chart like that, and then you can find where these closes occur. And you can see that we had, see, it lines up pretty nicely with all of these. You know, the wick's going to be there. Here we had a close on it, and this is where the departure left from. And so we also have a round number here, the 50 figure and the big figure up here. And so we can expect that we might have a correction, move back up into this area of 4 hour supply, and then a departure. And this is supply because we managed to move through the area that these price points were testing historically here. Okay, so if I just mark that area off, it's a tiny area, we'll mark it off nonetheless. So it looks like that, tested, remove, price went up. Okay, so advertising high prices, I wish to sell, then price left. And so this could be an interesting area that we could see price retreat from. And due to the fact that it's not a stunning one, I'll just put a very small one in there like so. Matter of fact, I can move my stop above here and put my entry just here. Right, so what does that give us? Put a tiny one in there. Stop 139.22, 139. Take profit, we'll do that in a second. This is 4 hour. 138.46, 138.46, and we want this to run it will let it run until later. We'll let it go till 8 o'clock-ish tonight. Okay, so if that manages to do anything, we have a one-to-one there. So let's find an obvious place, and the obvious place would be around here. See how price tested this area? We tested it. Then price managed to turn around from this point here. So we'll probably see some kind of reaction there, which is also the big figure. So we'll leave that in there and see what happens. All right, let's remove all of these and continue our analysis. Let's look at something else. Look at the pound Australian dollar. Okay, so on the weekly chart, what are we doing? Wow, we're really selling. This is just the whole Brexit uncertainty. And so we do have this huge pushing higher and lower, and then a massive departure. So let's just box this off. This is the origin of that move. Go to the high. We'll go to the daily and see what's inside there. And so if you see here, again, we can use that little trick where you put the line bar on, you find where those lines were, those price points where price respected price historically. You can see that we had respect for this level here. Around here and around here. So this is just at the edge. So going to the 4-hour chart and looking at this. okay, here we had the area that was tested. This one removed it. Okay, let me remove this now. We know where that is. This one removed it. It was tested. Sell zone a little bit deeper. Here, price went deeper. And this is where we left from. So we have to find something opposing. So an area that was respected historically. You can see we have something down here. So a lot of respect, test. So that's telling us that we have something in here, just here. Lines up pretty nicely with the wicks here, and this is the area that caused that that removal of this area of demand. So you can move this back up here, get rid of that, and then we have something here. A little bit ugly, but let's look on the small time frame, see if we can pinpoint something. And then yes, you can see that this is the departure, but higher up is better, because this is where we had, you can see how we had a tiny area here of demand. This is demand, it moved above this high. This is supply, because it moved above below this low. Tested, removed from right there. So you might want to do something like that, putting the stops above there, and go back to the 4-hour and see what that looks like. That looks pretty interesting, I'd say. Okay, so a retracement back up into this area could be quite interesting. Note that price has traded quite a lot in that area, so maybe half a position size from that point on, but it was a very nice departure. It's already getting pretty close to the big figure up and around here. So we'll have to see what happens at that precise point. Let's have a look at something else. Let's look at the pound American dollar. These are interesting pairs at the moment. So if you see the same thing happening here, we had a lot of testing. Testing. This one removed it. The origin of that is up here. This one did it. Software found it for us right there. It was tested. This one removed it here. Okay, parent, child, tested. This one removed it. This is where it is. It was tested, and now it went down. And then this one here was the one that caused price to close below these lows here. And this has also been tested already. Testing, and now price is gone. And so, yeah, the train's already left the station. But on a smaller time frame, maybe there might be some nice continuation patterns away from that area. And I mean, this is what we saw here. We had a very nice test. You can see this area is very nicely tested. If you put this on the line chart, you can see how this was a very nice area here, respected historically testing. We had no closes above it. A little bit, we came down, we closed on it, and then we left. And so this is kind of the origin of the price move that moved down. But it's a pretty ugly area, as you can see, because there's a lot of trading in that area. But I like how price managed to move higher, and then we cut away. So that's telling us that we have a keen interest in selling from about that point. But looking higher, we also have this, which also looks very interesting. If we have a look at that, this is just a very nice departure as well. And you can see when price left here, we managed to cause a continuation pattern below this. Price tried to come back, we tested this, and then we've already come down. So technically speaking, price has already been back to this area. It's already traded pretty nicely throughout here. So this would be a better idea from about this price point here. Let's have a look at the American dollar, Canadian dollar. And so we have this lovely, this is a very short-term trade that I've just put in. We have a very nice tiny little area just around here. We might have a bit of a bounce. So this is one that I'm going to have to manage pretty aggressively, see how that goes. But a poke up into this area here, and then a small retracement back down to the highs around here, it might be quite interesting. We'll have to wait and see what happens from that price point. Okay, I'm going to leave it at that. If you have any questions, please send them in. Thanks for